It's up to us as adults to help kids and teens remember again and again to stop the comparison trap, as it results in unhealthy feelings about their own bodies, social lives, and self-esteem. Hi, I'm Dr. Mitch Prinstein, APA's Chief Science Officer, here to give you some advice on how to help your kids and teens avoid the harms that can come from making comparisons on social media. It's easy for teens to become critical about how they stack up to others on social media, and in most cases, it results in teens feeling bad about their own bodies, their social lives, or themselves. It's natural to compare ourselves with others, and it's also easy to make errors based on what we see online. When you see someone seemingly perfect on social, do you feel a little self-conscious or envious? Or do you immediately start recognizing the ways that the post might be curated or filtered? Maybe just a computer-generated image of a person who doesn't even exist? Kids and teens are especially likely to feel self-conscious, and maybe even more influenced by what they see on social than adults. That's because a natural part of adolescents' psychological development is to form an identity based on how they are the same or different from adults and from their peers. Social media has made this hard, so it's up to us to help teens remember again and again to stop the comparison trap. Here are 5 tips. Number 1, social media posts usually reflect our best curated selves, which is far from our real lives. Number 2, social media posts can be created, altered, or manipulated to not reflect reality. Number 3, many social media profiles are developed by bots or computers, and don't even represent a real person. Number 4, we're used to living in an offline world, and our brains do amazing jobs making us believe what we see. But on social media, this no longer applies. So it takes practice to remind ourselves every day to question, doubt, and verify what we see. Number 5, ask your child or teen whether social media makes them feel better about themselves or worse after they've used it, and help them feel supported if they want to take a break or get together with peers face-to-face instead. I hope this helps. For more information, please go to apa.org.